So welcome to the Wednesday, May 4th, 2016 Committee Preservation Committee meeting. We are missing Julia, who is not feeling well, and our other David will be a little bit late. As always, we start the meeting with general public comment. Is there anyone who would like to comment on anything? If not, we will move to the approval of minutes, April 6th and 20th. Did we get the 20th?
Just the 6th.
I didn't see the 20th.
Just the 6th?
I'm going to approve the minutes for the 6th.
Second.
All in favor? All opposed? Okay, the chair's report. So Justin, talking to Sarah briefly, as I think all of us know, we're still down a person from housing. There's no one on the, is it the housing, what is the?
Housing Authority.
Housing Authority, who is interested in being a member of this.
Interested or able.
Interested or able, right.
People in conflict.
And so we're still waiting on that, and at some point, Sarah said it might be kicked back to city council, and there'll be a city council. So in the meantime, Linda, you're our housing person. We bow to you. The other thing is that those of us that were looking at your email got something from the state about the CPC, CPA funding, which seems to be a good thing, Sarah?
It's not as good a thing as they made it sound. That's significant, they're significantly down from last year.
Oh, really?
So it's more money than the base amount, but not nearly as much as.
Oh, okay. So the headlines don't always say what it is, is that right? And we'll know the full amount when?
Not until the fall.
Not until the fall.
It's also the thin amount of budget surplus, right?
So if there is no budget surplus, then we don't get any extra money.
And we will theoretically would know that in advance of our, beginning of our fall round, or do we generally not know until October?
We don't know until somewhere in the middle, but we start to be able to guess how much.
Good. All right, so as.
Procedural question, what does our schedule look like?
Our schedule is we are attempting to wrap everything up this evening.
Okay.
And I don't even know if we have another meeting scheduled, do we?
We don't at this point.
Until fall.
Up to the committee.
Up to us.
If there's any expedited applications that come in, you can schedule it around that, but we also don't have any money. I'll try and discourage.
So as we may hopefully remember from last time, in our deliberations, we had questions regarding the Plasky Park, not just Phase 2, but the Phase 1 as well. So Jim, thank you so much for taking your time to come once again in front of this, committee. So, I don't know if you want, Jim, to, if you had prepared anything, or if you want us just to begin firing our questions at you. I thought it might be helpful just a little update, if there is one, on what Phase 1 renovations, how that's going, if there's anything to add since we saw you last.
Sure, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to update Ariel Dunker from Simpson Associates with me tonight. Ariel is helping manage the construction contract with Mountain View, so he's a little bit closer to it than I am at this point, because we're aligned in a little bit, so maybe just give you a little update on the status of the Phase 1 job.
Okay, great, thank you for coming.
Of course, happy to be here. Like Jim said, I work for Stephen Simpson Associates, I'm the project manager. I work directly with Stephen Lauren, the principals. I was actually out and about, out walking around. I didn't expect it to be as muddy. But everything is looking great. There's still a lot to be done, but we're working as efficiently and as quickly as we can. I guess, what kind of updates were looking for?
Whatever you feel is necessary, we weren't really looking for anything in particular.
I think we were interested in the status of the change orders, because there was still some reserve there and, for Phase 1, and whether there's been any more dipping into that or anticipated to be, or whether you think there'll be some funds left over, and so.
We're anticipating that some of the contingency funding will be left over. We've been judicious in approving change orders. One of the change orders that we approved recently involved changing from seeding the main lawn area to using sod. So the areas, and the idea there would be to make the park open and available for people to use right away. So area rather than roping off areas and waiting for grass to become all established, we decided to pay more to have sod come in for the main green area and some other areas that would be more high traffic. So that was one of the change orders that was recently approved. But we're not expecting really any other change orders at this point. And I think the way we look at it is if there's more, when you start the job and you're doing work that's underground, that's when you tend to find things that you don't expect. And now a lot of that work, foundations and things for the deck and the seating and that sort of thing, that work is done, so we're at the point where we're above ground, and the choices that we make on spending any contingency money are like that, which is, you know, sod versus seed, or another change order that we decided to buy a few more tables and chairs for the seating area at the Pulaski Plaza. That was $1,000 more. So little things that we're doing here down the stretch, but we're not really expecting anything beyond that.
Yeah. One of the things we were scratching our head about was the space behind the academy, and that quickly led to a realization that we didn't quite know where the academy's property ended, even though it technically, I guess, it still belongs to the city, but where the academy's area of supervision ended and where the city's directly began. And also, we were concerned that adequate arrangements have been made to ensure that back area is not a problem area. If I can sort of summarize it, because there've been a number of cases of cars parked very haphazardly and cars that block both view and access, and even provide some danger to pedestrians or park users. So can that's probably the real pinch point in our discussions, more than the front, you know, a main street area.
Sure.
What can you tell us about that?
Well, what I can tell you is that the property line for the park goes almost right up to the academy building. So it's really all park line, except for a very small strip. But, you know, historically it's been sort of a shared use to get to the loading area for the academies. But it is all park line. Almost right up to the limit of the building. And there's been a lot of discussion. Actually, at the last meeting here, I talked to Deborah J. Anthony, who's the executive director of the academy, after about the parking issues back there. And what she told me is that oftentimes there are cars that are parked back there that have nothing to do with the academy, and she's been quite upset about it, and apparently had been meeting with the mayor's office and parking enforcement about what to do. Can they tow the cars out of there? You know, what can they do right now to take care of the problem? What we were proposing was the use of bollards to restrict access, and that the academy would have keys, but it would only be for access for shows, and that the changes and improvements that we would make behind that building would be for park use. So unless there was an event at the academy, that side would have some elements like Pulaski Plaza, which is on Main Street, where you've got some pavers and you've got movable tables and chairs and some nice landscaping. So it becomes another element of the park. And then on the nights they have shows or they need to get a production in, then the tables and chairs can be removed, the pavers are suitable for traffic, bottles will be removed, and they can come in with a truck that they need and unload. So it really is more about taking that space, which has been sort of underutilized and used more by the academy and for all this like random parking things that are happening, and to really reclaim that space as park for park use. And I had a long email from Andrew Crystal, who's the chair of the board of directors for the academy, and he actually contacted me, sounded quite upset about some of the cost elements for the CPA grant application round to make changes behind the academy. And he told me, you know, we don't need anything that fancy, and this is all we need, and I'm shocked at the price. And what I told him was that if we just put the basic things in to make it suitable for just trucks, it would be less money, but it's a park space, and we're trying to make it consistent with the park design and usable as parkland. So it's because of those things, you know, you have money for landscaping and pavers and things that are nice so they can be a shared space and not just bring paving in or build a loading dock or something that would only be more sort of like a commercial or industrial, whatever, access for them to get to the cabin. So he was sort of misunderstanding. The goal of the application was really to make that, to reclaim that space as park space and have better operational control over it. And after I explained it all, I think he was fine. But he was envisioning something, you know, merely from their standpoint, all we need is this, and I can either get a truck in, but you know, we said it's park space. So it's landscaping, it's control of the space, it's tables, and you know, something that would make it nice for people to use.
Kevin?
So, first off, I appreciate knowing where the boundary is. I mean, it's always been an uncertainty to me. I think my question is more to Ariel, because I have been on the committee as long as we've been funding the project.
Mm-hmm.
And so I heard Lauren's first presentation, and at that time I was really concerned about a crosswalk that came out of the back of the park and had a fatality in town a year or two before.
Mm-hmm.
That crosswalk got moved, but I know in that discussion we talked about my concern for the parking and the back area behind the park.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been a real thorn in Jim's side about, you know, this is something we had expected in the first design. So to see this design work come up now is upsetting to me, to say the least. And I don't think it's Jim's management of the project. I think it's not having heard the requirements when we were talking about them in the beginning. So you just get a piece of me. That's how that goes. Jim, for you, I've got a question, though, that I think it's a practical one. For all of the construction vehicles that have been parked in that back area, is it going to receive the sod? Is that going to have been so compressed that you're going to have to work on it before it can? I mean, what is the situation in that area going forward?
Well, we were certainly careful during construction to make sure that root zones around the trees and things were protected and that the construction vehicles aren't operating in an area where they would impact the trees. Actually, a lot of the work left has to do with placement of soils, suitable soils for future, for the plantings that come in at the end of the job.
Yeah.
So I think any area that's been, the soils have been compacted, those areas will be reworked and aerated. And in a lot of cases, special soils for planting is being brought in and being placed on top of materials that are there. So that's more sort of a subsoil type area. It was actually quite amazing when the soils plan that Stinson had put together, and the specifications are very rigid for planting soils, and the specifications for different areas of the park, depending on what was going to be planted, were pretty rigorous. So I'm pretty confident that everything will work out fine for the plantings. So it's hard, right? If you're going from construction site to...
Yeah, well, hard being the operative word. I have some raised garden beds sitting over an area that used to be a garden. I mean, it used to be a driveway.
Mm-hmm.
And nothing grows any deeper than that, no matter what I've done to that area.
Right. And I don't want to add anything to that area open with this.
I think the only thing I would add is for the existing trees, I know in our specifications, and we made sure that an arborist is present, you know, for areas where paving will be dug up and that proper care for the trees were done. And that's something I took note of today. I think everything was done well, you know, no apparent root damage was evident, so I feel confident.
Anytime work was done around the trees in sensitive areas, either Stinson was out or the parcelator or the certified arborist was out looking at any of the work. And the contractor, all they do is build parks, and they were quite careful and concerned about making sure that any trees that were to remain were properly taken care of. So there was a lot of discussion about the trees and making sure that they would, you know, be healthy in the function.
Well, I just, I'll stop after this, I promise, but I felt like when we last saw you that the academy had been able to layer on some parking requirements that we had not expected. I'm not sure that's true, but I think what we really want is just where you're going. We want park. You know, the academy does have to function, and they're doing a great job of functioning, but to start using that back area as parking again, it's going to be tough to change those habits. Anyway, thank you.
Sure, you're welcome. You know, I think the academy's support, I think they're in line. I mean, the discussions I've had with Deborah, they've been very good in this regard, and there have been some meetings in the mayor's office, and the mayor's clearly, you know, he's very focused on the park.
Yeah.
In a way that I think will result in the goals that we're talking about here.
I had a kind of an assumption made that the design behind the academy wasn't really finalized until after the other phase two project was done, and that's how we got a feeling of that it was tacked on at the end. But I assume, and that's another assumption, that because you're in there with equipment, now is the time to do that piece, rather than making it a phase three or something, that you've got equipment in there. And I hope I have that correct assumption, that, you know, the advantage of doing this in this timely way is that it will save money because you've already got people and equipment there.
Right.
Am I right?
the thinking is correct. There's two ways to make sure that the city gets the best value. There's basically a couple of different ways to build that, the changes behind the academy. One of them is to complete the design now, talk to Mountain View, the contractor that's already mobilized, and get a price from them to say, you know, how much it would take to do this additional work. And then we would work with Stimson to review the pricing to make sure that it looks like it's all, and, you know, that the pricing is fair and accurate. And if that's the case, then it could be added to Mountain View's contract. If for some reason we ask for a change order proposal from Mountain View, and they give us a price that looks really high, and the numbers are inflated, and it's not in the city's best interest to do it now, even though Mountain View is out there, we would add that that work to the phase two project, which will go out to bid, and then you know that'll go through a bid environment, and you'll get the best price through a bid environment. So there's really a couple of ways to do it.
Or even if there's any contingency left from phase two, that it could be rolled into that project.
Right.
Any savings that you have on, that you realize could then be used.
So could you correct my memory, is there a design, finished design for this area yet? Or
no.
I take it that there isn't.
No, there isn't. What we did for the application that we submitted to you was we asked Stimson to come up with a concept plan for pricing, just to get us in the ballpark of what it would be, mm-hmm. what the final design would need to be done, and drawings and details and things worked out for it. But we were trying to get in the ballpark for what was necessary.
Thank you. And you mentioned just, maybe not a huge issue, but you mentioned that the city's land goes almost up to the back of the academy. Well, just for clarity, how close is that? Approximately, I mean, is it 5 feet, 2 feet, 10 feet?
I'd say maybe about 5 feet.
Yeah.
So it's very, you know, it's almost too close, but historically, for whatever reason, that's the way the properties were drawn up. I would say we're about 5 feet.
And is it all the way through to South Street?
Yes.
So when we look at the proposal that you gave us, just to reiterate, all of this is a park proposal. None of this is structural changes to increase access into the academy or any of that. Is that correct? So I'm looking at like concrete landing and steps. Is that steps into the academy or steps?
Steps into the academy.
Okay. So how is that a part of Pulaski Park?
I mean, it's the interface between the two. The steps do serve the academy, but it's clearly an academy use and not for the park. They have steps out there now that are unsafe. There's some grading that would happen out behind the academy that allows more efficient use of the loading dock. But clearly, some of those elements are designed to facilitate the use of the academy, although they're on park land.
That's what we're really trying to tease out, is everything really eligible for CPA funds? And I confess, I'm still not clear. The steps are on the academy side of the line, or they're, because if they're not even on the park land, I'm not sure.
The steps are so close to the building, I think they're probably on academy land. Because they go up, there's some steps on the back. They're actually quite dangerous, I don't know the, anyway, the thinking is that if work is being done in the back, code issues with safety, that those should be dealt with during construction. If it's not an eligible expense under CPA, the grant, then we would leave it out, and then the academy would have to find another source to make that change.
That's our concern.
Yeah.
Is that this has to be park related, and steps to the academy is not historic preservation. It doesn't, someone correct me if I'm wrong, fall into our domain. Let me make sure.
I'm not sure I'm as bothered by it as you are. We've spent so much of this committee's money on the academy in the past, and I accept that it's an interface between those two right now. But I still say my comment is to Stimson. The design work being charged again is not right. And so I want to go on record as saying that's the piece that's upsetting me. And it's not the builder, it's not the city's oversight, it's the fact that we thought we were buying that design already. So that's just for the record again. But as far as the steps and those sorts of things, I think we have to do them.
I would add that this committee has spent tens of thousands of dollars on steps on outside the academy which in the form of the fire escape renewal. And if this is renewal of steps rather than providing new steps, then it seems like it comes closely enough to, as a safety issue, to, and I agree with Devin, that they're both city properties, it doesn't offend me as long as it is renewal and not some redesign of the back, you know, that would involve lots of new landscaping.
Yeah, this is just so close. When we had a meeting with the academy and Stephen was out that day, and we were really looking at the interface between the building and how that would work with making this sort of a more park element in there. There's some existing stairs that will remain, and there's just a new stair added to make it safe, and then there's another set of, there's a small set of concrete stairs that's shown on here that would make access to the back for, you know, for people essentially to make that safe. So it's actually shown conceptually on the plan that was submitted. That's really what it is. I mean, it's not a ton of work. I forget what the estimate was for it, but it's clearly safety and an issue where we're going to be grading and doing paving work or paver work so close to that you know, the idea is not the same.
Can I also just add that I also support Devin's other comment, and I've been here even longer than she is. My understanding of this design work was that it was going to be done near the end of the project because there were loose ends. There was this interface between the park and the academy, and that for that reason it was best done a little bit later. But that there was no sense to me that it was not covered as part of the original design bit. And for that reason, it's not for me to review the city's purchases, but I would certainly encourage whoever is responsible for this to take a look at the contract and keep that price very low at this point, because it does feel odd to me that it's being charged as an extra.
How much is in this academy portion being charged for design to Stimson?
$31,000.
I think that's subject to contract review by the city, not for this committee, but.
I'm sorry, Brian, that's in this current request.
Right. And the $31,000 is just for behind the academy, correct?
That's right. It's for, yes, for all the areas shown in the concept plan. we would negotiate the final fee with them. That's probably a conservative budget number, because quite honestly, dealing with the academy is taking a lot of time. And their extension's expectation, Stephen's expectation was that there'd be multiple meetings with Andrew Crystal and people from the academy to make sure that appropriate coordination has happened. And we're doing our best in that regard, but it's not, they're very interested in every little thing, even though it's park land. So it's been time intensive.
Jim, you're shooting for dominating the conversation, but you're absolutely clear in your mind that this area was not part of the original design bid. Is that right?
Well, we asked them to design something that was designed and was in the month of your contract. So they sought input from us, from the city, on the elements of design and what the approach was going to be on the park. So we talked a lot about these things, including the area behind the academy, what Mountain View is under contract to build right now, and that design, that basic design was what we did okay during the phase one design process. So there's different levels of design. What Mountain View has under their contract is very simple grading and placing of stone, and there's some other work there, but it's not, you know, it's obviously not as nice as what we're looking to do with this change in the design. So we had approved what Stinson did under the contract, and now we're asking for that work to be redone in more detail.
That's helpful, thank you.
Actually, that's a good point for where I wanted to ask my question. Assuming for a moment, because that, in addition to the design, the $31,000 for the design, which you say is a fluid number, there's $142,000 included for construction, I assume, based on that design. Hypothetically, if none of that money is made available, what does that leave us with? What is it that you're currently under contract, or that we're currently contracting for? What do we get?
You basically get a new gravel area behind the academy, with really not too many other changes.
What kind of either visual or physical barrier is there between the area where the cars are currently parked and the park itself?
I think we have removable bollards in there now. So the idea was to still limit the traffic even under the original plan.
But where would the bollards be positioned along South Street, or are they in closer to the park themselves?
I think they're by the, not too far from the sidewalk on South Street.
Okay, so there's no sort of either visual like planting or any sort of barrier between. So if you could imagine in your mind that where we current, almost where the fence is right now, if we wanted, and I think the current sort of semi-proposal for the next phase puts like a stone wall there and some plantings, is there anything, would the stone wall and the plantings be replacing anything that's currently under contract? Is there anything at all that breaks up visually your line of sight to South Street, or physically your ability to access it if the bollards aren't in place?
I think the only visual barrier we have is with the play areas. We've got a visual barrier, I think, right, with some plantings that would, so if you're in the area where sort of the play area, the nature play area, there's the visual.
Right. You won't be seeing the loading dock. You'll be seeing a planted hedge. So visually and physically, it is the purpose of the screening.
Okay.
But between the loading dock and South Street, it's mainly just bollards.
Yeah.
Yep. And I had a conversation with Lauren about a concrete wall.
Right.
I did not go to the rock wall just for expense, but I mean, that conversation has been had early.
Yeah. No, I guess my concern is, and I think it was building off something that somebody said earlier on, which is, if the bollards aren't in place, there's an event going on at the academy, what's to keep, under the current design, what's to keep cars, trucks, whatever, from spilling over into what is clearly the park portion of what's going on.
The wall we were talking about then was coming right back off the inside park corner of the academy and coming down almost parallel to the sidewalk. and it was in the context of trying to keep the foot traffic from, you know, spilling out through that larger area, which we're trying to funnel it.
Does it work, you think?
That's what showed up in the next design, is the rock wall.
Okay. All right, thank you. Thanks, Jim.
Sure.
Could I just clarify one last thing? Are there, for the loading dock, are there any changes to the dock itself, or is it just the grade to the dock that's been proposed to be changed?
Just the grade to the dock.
But if the proposal says a 45-foot box truck backup to the main loading dock, what does that mean?
So right now, a box truck backs up, and it's not at the right level to walk out of the box truck into the loading dock. So the idea is to drop the grade so that if the truck backs up, it's at the level where they can walk out from the truck into the loading dock. So it's a drop in the grade, so it becomes more of a straight shot in.
Can you control the water runoff to the foundation?
We can. That was something that Stephen had looked at when we were out. He took some measurements, and we walked around and went inside the building with Andrew Crystal. We did take a close look at that.
Other comments about behind the academy? Questions for Jim or Ariel about phase two? Do we have any of that? Good to go on that?
Maybe it's foolish
because
of the money,
which
never mind.
Talk
myself
out of
it.
Any other questions? Well, Jim is here. Are we done with this?
I think.
I wanted to take a second if I could have it all. So, thanking Jim. Jim is, as you, most of you know, moving on to Springfield, and we wish him well. And I've been on this committee longer than any of you, and I've seen Jim come before us innumerable times and has consistently answered our questions with an unflappability and a thoroughness and calmness that is much appreciated, because I never feel like I'm being bamboozled when Jim is up here. And it's a rare talent, and I appreciate it. I did get used to your style at first, but I really appreciate it. And Springfield gained is our loss, and certainly wish you well in your work down there.
Here.
Yeah. Are you moving before or after the completion of the last year?
I think we've got him on his last week. I can't
Friday, your last day tonight.
It's my last week. My last day is Friday.
Oh,
I'm still going to live in Florence, and my wife and I aren't moving. And I'm already planning to attend the ribbon cutting for the park. And,
good.
Is this your last night meeting on behalf of the city?
And he certainly could have passed it up. That's my point.
After tell us how you really feel about things.
I appreciate the saying those kind of things about me. I actually plan on thanking everybody on this committee for all the work that you do on behalf of the city and serving our committees, because it's a lot of work, I understand, particularly this committee. And your great responsibility for funding and going through applications and trying to be fair in the way that monies are managed and grants are handed out. And it's a pretty tall order. And it's been, my exposure toward it has been very positive. So, you know, thank you for all your work on behalf of the city. And I think it's a good thing.
Thank you. After today's event in downtown Springfield, you have much less to supervise than you did 2 days ago.
That's right.
I was busily trying to wrap up my Northampton business, and I was getting a little flood of email about a good warning.
A flood of email? You can't use that word.
Hopefully that'll be fixed before I start.
So thank you, Jim. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good question. You're welcome to stick around, but.
And Jim had attended enough civic meetings.
Okay, so do we want to continue discussion on the Pulaski Park stuff, or are we good? We had made, there was a motion and it was approved to fund in full and to be bonding that for 10 years. Does the discussion that we just have change how we feel about any of that? Do we want to, need to revisit the Pulaski part?
No, it makes me feel better about those.
Yeah, I would.
It's five years from now, and, Ed and I wanted, Jim's.
Well, we can certainly, we don't want to revisit everything, but we could revisit the bonding. Or I guess the larger question is, well, let's stick with this before the bonding. Devin, how are you with this?
My opinion on bonding hasn't changed, nor is there a way to go forward with it unless we do. I feel like we will just eventually, the funding stream will continue to decrease, and we eventually won't have need for having CPA meetings because we'll just be paying off the bond. Having said that, I'm going the way of the committee on this.
Well, I guess I was specifically asking, how do you feel about the 30, what was it, 31,000?
31,000.
I've said my piece, and I thank you for indulging me tonight. I wasn't speaking to the city, I was speaking to what I knew my history with the design firm had been. And I don't know that I would put this project at risk for $31,000. And I think we've gotten their attention on doing what's a really critical piece of design work for the park. So, I'm like Linda, I feel better.
And we're good with, you know, the steps and the loading dock stuff that is clearly academy and not park related. I mean, are we feeling, and Sarah, no red flags go up for you about that, with that?
I wouldn't think so. I mean, it's facilitating use of a park. It's on or very close to park land.
But it's facilitating use of the academy.
Well.
If it's a loading dock, it's the academy, it's not the park.
But it is on, I mean, it sounds to me like it is on park land, you know.
And I think comment he made before is that they need to do grading anyway.
And the grading is on the park land.
Okay. So just to make sure we're not worried about that. Okay, everybody's good to go on that?
I don't think the expenses are really high on that side of the ledger either.
Not to be broken record, but I do agree with Devin's point about the fact that both the design firm and the contractor seem to have they're pulling money out of the city a little bit here. I think because it was left a little bit vague, with not every I dotted and T crossed, they're now they're now building the minimum. They've designed the minimum. So both of them are in on that, in that sense, and that was not the discussion at the time. And I feel a little bit taken. I also completely share Devin's good reason that that's not something I would delay a bond over. It is something that I would want to be very careful about in the future, however, with any major project like this. That we make sure that every last thing is designed to the finest point before we commit to funding it.
Yeah, it might be useful. Well, probably should have thought to say this while he was here, except that he'll be gone. I really don't want to see another request for funds because it comes when they put this out to bid, behind the academy out to bid, it comes in higher.
Well, can I say that I expect that? I mean, that the simple.
But what I was going to suggest was that the other letter say something about us anticipating that they would hold the current contingency reserves until they've gotten through to make sure that those could be available for the academy. Rather than anticipating coming back.
Well, and that's where I do respect Jim's management of the project.
Yes, but he's not going to be here.
I understand that. But my worry is we have gotten the first phase of the park, which is just about as simple a design as it can be. I mean, if there's nothing, you know, there's cord platforms and sidewalks, yeah. A very open green space, and now we're headed into a zigzag all the way down the hill, and that's just begs for complications. So I'm worry, but, you know, I think we've started this process, we should see it through as best we can, it's not my feeling.
I don't know how these things look when they're finalized, but, I would be very comfortable with including language somewhere in the award that says, we're very supportive of this, and because of that, we went to what we consider to be extraordinary measures to come up with the money. We anticipate, because times are tough, and we anticipate that if anything, they're going to be much tougher in the future, and that we seriously question whether additional resources for this project will be available for us to decide on in the future, and just lay it out there and say, look, you know, you may have had your last bite at the apple and plan accordingly.
That's what I was, something along those lines is what I was trying to suggest.
Yeah, no, I'm just building it. I'm just not sure where it goes, having to put one of these things together.
I don't know that I would put it in a contract, that doesn't sound like contractual language.
It's not contractual language, no.
But a cover letter.
Yeah, but I, you know, as we said, in a couple of other instances where we wanted to fire a warning shot across the bow of potential future grantees, this is definitely a case where, you know, my one concern about this project, and I never had any concern about funding it, is, but when you get into a project that's this large and you're this far into it, you literally almost have a gun to your head to not, you know, I mean, you're not in a position where you can say no because you're so already so deeply invested. And I think that that becomes more acute in the future, even as resources become scarcer. And we might, you know, just want to offer them a word of caution about coming back, you know, one more time.
David, you just missed Jim and Ariel, who's from Stinson, so there's...
I apologize for the
benefit of, no, we are not, you were... Sarah, what Chris was bringing up would not go into the city council orders, is that correct?
I don't think so. It seems most appropriate for a cover letter, just as a disclaimer. Here's your agreement, by the way, we don't really want any money.
Okay. Okay. Great.
You want to summarize, or they, what we learned?
Sure, Linda, why don't you go ahead and do that. Thank you for offering.
Jim made pretty clear that the redesign is for purposes of making it appropriate for park use. That the line is almost up to the academy building, the dividing line, so that
literally feet of the academy.
So that the improvements are really all going to be made on what is park land, except for some steps. Except for some steps. And what was there before would basically have been just graded gravel, and I think the movable bollards and a hedge, I guess, is what we learned, separating the phase one from this area. So this is what draws it into being part of the park, makes it usable. There will be tables and chairs there. Those will be moved when there's academy function to allow it to be parked. The bollards will be in place with a key, except for when there is an academy function for which they need to be able to
then release that.
So I think people seem to be reassured that this is a park expense.
Yeah, that's encouraging.
Devin was articulate and assertive in stating her concern that the $31,000 that's budgeted for perhaps should not have been there, or some concerns about that design work. Why is it there when it should have been there?
Right.
And they were sort of met with stony silence, and they really didn't respond.
Stinson, he probably wasn't involved.
He was not.
I couldn't tell whether it was really a blind spot
from this, on the city's part. I mean, you made a major point very well, and they basically didn't ask it of Simpson. So what they asked Simpson may have provided, I was left unclear.
It's quite likely.
Really, whose fault that was.
It's quite likely that they might have different opinions on the validity of that fee.
But it seems like the consensus of the committee is that we feel comfortable moving forward
yeah.
with our recommendation in full. And we really didn't ask much about phase two at all, did we? You almost did, rather than. You almost close to it.
Is that where you were going?
Yeah.
Okay.
I would say my experience of phase one doesn't make me excited about going into phase two. I must say that just because of the business environment, not the design, but the business environment.
What do you mean by the business environment?
Well, I mean, to take the project to an equally large piece with all the same players, you know, the same design company.
Deb, it seems to me one of the ways to prevent this innovation from re-arising, and I share your concern, would be for us to make very sure that there's no corner or element within that phase two that is vague or undesigned at this point, because we now know that if it's left at all vague, that there's going to be a...
But how would we possibly do that?
Well, just by looking at it. Now, if you were to look at what was at the design phase behind the academy, in the beginning, there was some discussion, absolutely, here and there, and there was an understanding that it would be more finished by the end. But the actual design on paper was vague. And unfortunately, nobody made it more specific, and then the builder built it to design, which is, as you said, just going to pour some gravel on it, and it got left that way. And now when we say, wait a minute, that's not nearly what we want, they say, well, we're going to up the design cost. When there was a casualness to that very, I think everybody thought it was an understanding at that very, at the, when it came to that element behind, right behind the academy. And it didn't work out that way.
I'm wondering whether it makes sense to either ask staff person if you wouldn't feel uncomfortable doing this, I don't know, or you as the chair to meet with Jim's replacement. And because I don't know if they're really going to read, she's really going to read a cover letter, but to go over at some point, you know, not immediately, when she's settled into the job a little bit, go over the history, make her aware of how much funding has come from CPA funds, and the several surprises and requests for significant increases that have come before the committee, and the feeling that basically the committee is tapped out, so that she, you know, has that mindset, understands the history, understands that they've been back to this well, not just for the core funding, but for several significant increases in funding. And
I think that's a great idea. Yeah. She starts when? Is this
so Jim's replacement, which is which hat? Jim has three hats on currently. So we have a, so the city just appointed a DPW director. We do not have a city engineer.
That's true. Well, would this be?
It depends on how things get out, probably. I don't know how much involvement should the new.
That's a good point.
Things are in flux.
But we could try to meet with someone at some point.
Yeah, I think it's a great idea when we do have a city engineer to talk to.
Yeah.
There is no city engineer. Somebody's going to be overseeing.
Somebody will
it.
Eventually. I mean,
well,
between now and when we actually start, I mean, there's a long window now we're going to be in. So I think the city will.
How long the window is it going to be, really?
Well, who was overseeing the project now when Tim left?
Dave, probably. Yeah. Wouldn't it be?
And Dave, who's Dave?
Dave Valletta. He was also
an engineer. He was the guy.
He came.
Yeah, that's why he was here. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you mean about the gap? Aren't they starting up again? I mean, are they?
Well, so Jim is leaving. Did you catch
no, I'm
that?
Aware of that, but a gap in construction.
Well, I mean, this funding round we're talking about has to go through the council, and then, I mean, I just see that there ought to be a little bit of time before they actually are doing phase two? They're gonna, I don't think they've got the design work for phase two all firmed up yet, it's not bad.
It looked pretty complete, I mean, they could build from that, from what we saw, I think.
But they have not gone out to bid for that. I don't believe that's true.
They can't until they have funds in hand.
Is there, there's no way that they could just attach it to as a change order to the previous contract?
That's what I don't want them to do, I want them to have to bid it.
Yeah.
It's a lot of money to not.
Not aware, yeah.
So I think, Linda, I think it's a great suggestion, and Sarah can let us know when she feels there's an appropriate person that she can talk to, or I can talk, go with Sarah. And make that, that gets, that's good.
And if it's possible, it'd be helpful to me not just to be there as a fly on the wall, to help me get up to speed on the history of the project to date. Because, yeah, I'd love to just sit in.
Well, the other thing is.
I promise not to make any trouble.
It depends when this comes, I mean, we could ask her to come to a meeting.
I was heading that direction.
Her or him, if it's, what was his name again?
Dave.
Dave?
David Villan.
Yeah, whoever is, whoever will be supervising. So that may make sense for that, for whoever's in charge to appear before us and we can.
Maybe, I don't want them to feel defensive, I want it to be.
But if it's a new person taking on, we're not, and I don't think we're, we are attacking them, we're just stating what our limitations are. I mean, right?
Yeah.
And it might be helpful or better to have them come to the committee. But we'll figure that out. Okay, so does it make sense to move seamlessly into reviewing and approving the council orders that Sarah gave to us? Because in doing so, if one allows us to look back on or reflect on what we decided 2 weeks ago, but also to look at the conditions that are important that we set. And if red flags or if second thoughts have come up, that as we go project by project, looking at conditions and looking at the council orders, we can air those second thoughts if we have them or red flags. Does that make sense? I was thinking maybe while we're on Pulaski to start with the Pulaski one rather than the first one, which was the Northampton Conservation Fund. So what is it, page four something?
And on this one, we changed the bonding amount slightly from what was discussed at the last meeting just because we were cutting it very, very close to the amount of cash on hand. So I changed my.
Okay, so say that again, sir.
So the amount is the same, but the bonding amount went up slightly and the cash amount went down.
So we're looking at the very last.
We wouldn't have negative.
We're looking at the second page specifically. Now, I thought we had talked about a 10-year bond, no?
Yes, I have.
Okay, so the 5 goes to 10. So,
I got it.
So, new folks, David and Chris, this is really the time where conditions, we can set conditions within this order. This is where we put the conditions, right, Sarah?
It depends. So anything in here we're communicating to council, and if it gets changed, we'll have to go back to council for approval.
Okay.
But often we include all sorts of conditions that aren't in these in contracts.
Okay. And the time to do that is right now as well?
No. So actually, we will have to have one more meeting to approve those contracts.
Okay. Okay, so we woke up to, and that will
so
be.
So we can note any of that now, and I have all the notes from the last meeting too. But
will City Council need to see that before they? No. So our conditions can be set after City Council would approve.
Yes.
These orders, correct? Okay. So we don't have to be as specific within this. So let's start with the Pulaski Park one. And again, we had voted unanimously to approve full funding, the $805,000 for the Behind Academy and Phase 2.
And as Sarah stated, $130,400 comes right out of our budget of the $675,000. We're borrowing, and we're suggesting a 10-year bonding on that. Is there any additions?
Yeah, I just wonder if in the description, which is for overlook expansion, we want to also reference the area behind the academy, which isn't really.
Is that a whole new whereas, Linda?
No, I think, yeah, I think it could be.
And the area to the rear of the academy.
So that's in the first whereas, correct? Specifically the overlook expansion.
It's overlook expansion.
And then in the now therefore be it ordered as well, first.
So the Pulaski Park Road for overlook expansion and, and what are we calling the academy?
It's in their application. It's on the application.
Area to the rear of the Academy of Music.
It's not succinct.
No. And,
they couldn't figure it out.
Sarah, are you coming with language? The Academy's ass?
New South Street Park entrance? Is that something there?
Why not just call it the area to the rear of the Academy?
We could just like this.
Yes. That probably makes sense. Why did Doubt use their language?
You don't have to sing, it doesn't have to rhyme, right?
You don't have to sing it, no.
Okay, are there other?
Yeah, the last whereas clause, it refers to support of the phase one project, is that correct?
I used the last one as a template.
That's what I thought.
Ooh, good pickup.
Phase two.
Good pickup. Thank you, Chris. So phase, well, to support, this is really phase one and phase two, right?
We could just say this phase.
This phase.
It is next.
Yeah.
Okay.
Excellent. It's like phase to read the language. Any other whereas's or change to whereas's? Any other now therefore be it ordered additions? Are we having slept on it for 2 weeks? Are we, do we feel the need to revisit 10 years? Is anyone not comfortable with that? I think we can still change what we did 2 weeks ago, correct me if I'm wrong. Are we okay with that?
I'd still prefer 5, but I'm still in the minority, so.
Anyone changing on that? No? So how are we going to do this? Are we going to take another motion on each of these projects to accept the city council orders as presented? Should we do this one by one?
I think you'll get them all together, probably the same way.
Okay, so we'll do that. All right, so let's go back to the beginning, how about? The $30,000 for the CONSCOM fund. Let's take a moment to look at the whereases. Okay, any additions to the whereas's?
Are we proofreading?
I think we're, yeah, are you catching something?
There's a period missing at the end of the third whereas.
Okay. Thank you. was picking up things that we could pick up.
Tell me Reed's budget.
Prepare it.
Call it a weakness.
Anything else on this one? Good to go? Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, moving on to the invasive plant eradication project, the PVC thing. Take a moment to read.
I'll preempt the Chris wanting it to be invasives in the first, whereas plural.
Spell check doesn't like the word invasive.
No, that's right.
Ditto on the third.
Well, it's invasive plants.
Right.
Okay.
Actually, it's just, we should just always use invasive plants, I think.
Actually, if we're.
Okay, so the first one says invasive plants.
Okay.
I think it's brown, it would be spotted brown nap weed. Is it nap weeds?
Well, but spotted, I thought it was, so spotted napweed and brown napweed, is it weed or is it?
Oh, it's spotted and brown.
Yeah.
There are,
two different species.
It's naps weed.
Naps. Surgeons general.
Do, I know we're getting probably too picky here. Glossy buckthorn, isn't that caps? Because it is a.
Sure, do whatever he says.
Well, but then brown napweed would be.
I think it would too.
Okay.
I think those are all going to
be.
Because it's a specific plant.
There's species named.
They are the name of the.
Do you know what it's the common name?
What is a common name? It is.
We could write them in Latin.
Even when it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Any other stuff on the Mr. Olay? Good to go?
Yes.
All right, moving right along to Sawmill Hills.
Trust, but possibly
not. Just for being really nitpicky, Sarah, the second whereas, I don't think there's a comma after connection, is there? That connection that we'll preserve. Get rid of the comma.
Would you really, in an order, abbreviate OPS?
Okay, yeah.
Or?
No. I'm just interested in doing
it. I can't remember. What is OPS?
I'll just explain planning and sustainability.
Oh, I think it's a good idea to spell that out. I know that's a good call. Okay, anything else on this one? Good to go? Okay, Pulaski we have done. We're moving right along. Hampshire County Homeless. Sarah, you do a great job of these.
Yeah, you really did.
It's hard to distill them.
No, you did a really good job.
Anything.
And don't think our nitpickiness is a.
Oh, that's fine.
Yeah, I mean, you succinctly capture the essence of what we're trying to do with.
You take courses in this. Whereas course. 400 level.
I could teach the whereas course.
And these do come with a cover letter as well. This isn't the only information that council.
My only question is on the first paragraph under the orders. I thought it was 6 to 8. They haven't really.
They don't have a building yet.
They don't have the building, so they don't. Or maybe, yeah, so 6 to 8.
Would it? I asked the committee's opinion. Would it be useful to note that this is our funding is to support capital expense and not to support recurring operations.
Yeah.
So whereas TPA funds will be used towards the purchase of.
Yes.
I want to, probably I want to put that in so that we don't get hit annually for ongoing support.
No,
and also so the public doesn't think that their money didn't be spent on operating costs.
Yeah, they have to do it consistent with their application, which would mean it would go for acquisition, but I think this makes it really upfront and clear.
And that may be a condition as well, once we deal with the conditions.
And that the property remains the property of the city, right?
Or no, it's not the property.
We're just giving it to this nonprofit?
Yeah.
I would like to report that I had a conversation with a person who previously sat on this committee that was our housing person, and he had experience with Dial Self and spoke very highly of it, so he was absolutely in favor of it.
I'm
greatly heartened to hear that. As a matter of stewardship, if we were to give $275,000 to a nonprofit for hard costs and through no fault of their own, withdrawal of all the funding, whatever, they suddenly could no longer proceed with the project 2 years after they entered it. Would we anticipate some share of the disposition of that real estate? Because frankly, I mean, you know, we wouldn't at 30 years, I mean, we probably wouldn't at 20 years, but you know, when we give money for real estate or for hard buildings, and we give them to a non-city entity. It's in all good faith, and we usually have the faith in well placed. But we also, I would think, would kind of protect the short-term position of the city to make sure that if something were to go bad, that we were not, we didn't look foolish for having supported something that was too short-term.
So I think the way that we address that is through the affordable housing restriction. So
yes,
we can't provide the funding until the affordable housing restriction is in place. So even if something happens to the parent organization, that restriction is still there. So whoever ends up running it will.
That's very helpful. Thank you. Yeah. So even if they're not doing it, then
somebody else is.
And I think from what I've called their proposal, they need to raise a whole lot of funds in order to be able to acquire the property. So. They're not going to acquire it and then try to raise 90% of the funds. They have to have a lot of it in hand before they'd be able to expend our funds.
Right. So, I mean, it could grow. Sometimes these agencies are functioning under the umbrellas of state programs that are solid 1 year, 5 years, and then suddenly the program changes due to Beacon Hill and all the money evaporates, and suddenly they own the property, good people, it's all working properly according to the existing model, but the model is suddenly broken through no fault of anybody here. So that's just what I was trying to speak to. But I think Sarah's comment is great. Our concern is housing. And
we're essentially blinding the restriction.
Yeah. We don't really care about the name of the organization per se.
Can someone remind me, is there a time restriction or statute of limitations in terms of from the date of giving them the money that they have to make the purchase?
It's
3 years?
It's 3 years unless we specify otherwise. So 3 years from the date of the signing of the contract.
Okay.
We could say less. We can't say more.
And for this, I wouldn't say less. No, I mean, it might take 3 years.
Yeah, 3 years.
To find something, yeah.
Yeah.
And for this one, some of the language that we were talking about last meeting about would be conditions, is that right?
Yeah, I thought about mentioning the restriction in here, but it didn't really seem super important to include in the actual council resolution, but critical, obviously, to include in the contract.
In the conditions, okay. Anything else on this? Okay, moving on to the Academy of Music.
Oh, Sarah, I don't know if this is an offline thing. Sarah, I don't know if you have a chance to talk to them. In the interim since our last meeting, I found out that a colleague of mine actually knows someone who has a nonprofit, and all they do is give money out to people to restore textiles in New England or the Mid-Atlantic.
Really?
So I asked actually Sarah to follow up with the Academy to see if they had reached out to these people. Simultaneously, who's a partner of mine, and it's a good friend of hers who says that this is not something that they would fund. So.
Yeah, so they did get in touch with them and they said that sounds like a great project, but it's
yeah.
not.
It's very close, but it's not. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, so the second round.
They were frightened though. Why? Are they not going to give us the money? But why?
Well, I mean, it looks like they're actually, I'm not sure why this isn't in their wheelhouse, but they are looking for good projects to do textile restoration. So when something else comes along, keep that in mind.
Nitpicky, the whereases, the middle two, there'd be a period, not a, what is that called?
Semicolon.
They should all be
semicolon, yeah.
But everywhere?
Yeah.
Except for the last one.
In every whereas?
Yeah. I'll fix that.
Oh, good to know.
Because they're not complete sentences.
So, Sarah.
Well, they're called whereas clauses. So.
That's the point. And then we talked about making it clear that we wanted the Academy to make it available for viewing. I don't know if the third whereas is to the point enough for everyone. That was my stab at it.
Comments about that? Are we good with that whereas, or do we want to make it more? Restrictive is the right word, opposite of restrictive.
We could say regular free tours, but I mean, it's going to be up to them to do it for the case, no matter what.
I think we can say it's thought to be the largest historic scenic curtain. Or it is the largest known. It's either thought to be, or it's the largest known.
I've been here, but it's
thought.
It is the
word.
Yeah.
Right. Do a wiki for the source of that opinion.
Do you know about it?
That source actually was from a theater curtain nonprofit in Vermont, right? But
I think that's good.
Yeah.
The curtains without borders.
Well, no, that was very passive. Somebody went.
I love it. God.
Okay, are we good with this?
Yeah.
All right, moving on.
Yeah, we've already kind of brought
it up. I don't know why this is two
repeats.
Are we missing something?
Yes, we are.
Historical
a particular concern to the woman who is busily knitting or crocheting in the back. Sarah, do you have a...
We're missing historical repeats.
So we're missing
I
two.
Did it.
Yeah, there's, yeah, I've got, yeah, the last two.
I don't know how to do that.
Yeah.
Let me see if I can make this screen work. Okay, skip the last two alphabetically.
No, it's never a good
so. Just in time. Can I do that?
Yeah.
Yeah, we were examining these earlier.
Oh, the.
What did it say?
Paul Spector.
Oh.
So we have two to deal with, correct?
Something.
We have the historic North Hampton. What was it, 22,000? What was it?
2,300.
2,300?
That's my note.
This cord must be in the throat. Let's see what it does.
That's just the one to make it work.
Come on, this is a third.
IT expensive.
Urban archaeology. Oh, this is actually done in the Congress. Yeah, it's a lot of new, the people signing their names and their dates of service, you know.
Username and password are?
No, I don't know what it's in before. I've never seen this thing before.
Well, like it says, enter the code. The code changes periodically.
8922.
I could read them. Or I could print them to the city hall and run up and get them.
What do we prefer? Can we have her simply read them to us? Is that okay? Yes?
I'm fine.
People are nodding?
Yeah.
Okay.
Boy, I tried.
Always struggle with technology. You're destined to struggle. Okay, which one do you want to do first?
Let's do Shepherd Barn first. So this one was a little bit different because we were funding something slightly different than what the original application was for. So ordered that whereas Historic Northampton Incorporated submitted an application for CPA funding for continued work to restore, renovate, and stabilize the Shepherd Barn at 66 Bridge Street and protect historic artifacts, whereas CPA funds will be used to complete dendrochronology research and secure the barn in preparation for the full restoration project, whereas CPA funds will be used to help secure an important historic resource that is valued by the community and the region on which the city holds a permanent preservation restriction, whereas all work will be consistent with the Secretary of the Interior standards for the treatment of historic properties, and whereas on April 20th, 2016, they voted unanimously. So 23 for that one.
Do you want to say where's something refer to the fact that they revised their application to request funds for dendrochronology, and I don't think it was for. The second word was you said they're securing.
Stabilization.
That was the 300.
Oh, they did
ask.
Yeah,
they asked for 300.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I didn't understand that.
I think they would have done the dating even in the original barn. So they should, it's such a small piece.
Oh, yeah.
It feels like they would have withdrawn it.
I thought that was additional that they decided to do.
No, it was in the original proposal.
Are we really securing the barn?
They said it would be $300. I don't know what they're going to do.
There's just a couple of roof holes in the roof.
Yeah.
I think they're really
up. Something really, really minor.
Yeah.
Okay. Keep it watertight.
But usually we attack it. I don't know if they they've revised their application in writing. Usually they incorporate it, so unless we somehow say it was revised to just be the, then we'll be asking them to do all of the work that they applied for $2,300.
So, and that application was revised. Should we say, because we don't run out of funds?
No, because they did it on their own.
To address a small portion before the project work can begin.
So a small portion of necessary
documentation.
So the first whereas is, whereas Historic Northampton Incorporated submitted an application for CPA funding for continued work to restore, renovate, and stabilize the Shepherd Barn at 66 Bridge Street and protect historic artifacts, and that application was revised to address a small portion of necessary documentation before the project can begin.
And then if you wouldn't mind continuing to read so I can put that together in my brain.
Whereas CPA funds will be used to complete dendrochronology research and secure the barn in preparation for the full restoration.
And you read the other whereas's on it?
Yes.
And the last part?
Yeah.
The money was
$2,300. And that's from the budget over there.
Questions? Yes. Good to go?
Good.
Yes? Okay, folks in the back, pay attention to this. last one.
Okay. Whereas First Churches of Northampton submitted an application for CPA funding for restoration of the Tiffany and Rose stained glass windows located in the sanctuary of the First Churches of Northampton. Whereas CPA funds will be used to secure an important historic resource that is valued by the community and the region on which Mass Historic holds a permanent preservation restriction. Whereas the project will enable these important historic artifacts to remain in Northampton. Whereas all work will be consistent with the Secretary of the Interior standards for the treatment of historic properties. Whereas on April 20th, 2016, the Community Preservation Committee voted unanimously to recommend that $213,000 in CPA funds be used to support the project.
I think the application was for more than those two windows, so we want to do the same thing. Not same thing, but it was an application to address more of the windows, and we voted to address the two windows, so to recommend funding for the two windows only.
But does City Council need to know that's a good care?
It depends on everyone, if you'd like to tell them.
Yeah. And then you would?
Yeah. I think that we ought to communicate that we just ran up against all what we can do.
And so that could be done in a cover letter or in the resolution or whatever sounds best for you. Yeah. Or both.
Is there a whereas First Churches serves as a community meeting house for something to get at the denomination or the community aspect of.
I think it's also something useful for the historical record that 100 years from now someone will understand that these windows were valued in a special way beyond the other windows. No offense to anyone who loves other windows also.
Well, we had talked about with the rose window being the face of Main Street, and the Tiffany being Tiffany. I don't know if that's a whereas. Then.
So one could be whereas, in addition to being an important historic resource, First Churches provides valuable social services to the community.
Social services and meeting in this case because they don't directly provide a lot of the social services.
Yeah.
Social services.
Could you start off by saying that whereas First Churches requested funds to renovate and restore windows within the church and then clarify that we would support.
I like that.
The development of the two of them.
Blessings.
Excuse me. That's great.
by sewers.
David, what was you're aware of? You got another one, right? And I can't remember.
I think it's just, as long as we differentiate that we're pulling these two into that as special.
Oh, okay.
So the first whereas is now First Churches of Northampton submitted an application for CPA funding for restoration of historic stained glass windows located in the sanctuary of the First Churches of Northampton. And then the last whereas is the CPC voted unanimously to recommend that $213,000 in CPA funds be used to support the restoration of the Tiffany and Rose stained glass windows included in the application.
Can you read them all? Sorry.
Okay, let's just put a number in the first one, just say how many windows they were asking for. That'll just differentiate that we didn't have to prepare 12 or whatever.
Oh, golly, that's a lot.
Somebody here might know.
We were just counting.
No.
Count faster. I think 12. Is there ever applauding or cheering in this meeting? Is that allowed from the...
Yes.
We've been trying to be quiet tonight.
No, you may applaud as desired.
Nullifies the
you don't get to. You didn't give us an hour and a half.
I'm just live tweeting.
Yes.
Here. You know, it's going out over the...
What's the time frame for the work now that we've created the money?
Say
12. I was counting 12.
That's a very good question. As
you didn't expect this, did you?
Well, well, slightly, but I think the time frame would be to probably start on the first window as soon as we can kind of get ourselves organized. I think we probably need to just have a conversation about what we have to do to properly put it out to bid and those kinds of things.
It also needs to go before city council.
Right, so we probably need to have a further conversation to make sure that we do everything accordingly.
Do you have the resource, do you know the resources for asking those, for answering those questions? I mean, will MHC be of any value to you?
I would think so. Well, I would assume that we would have to also alert them and get approval for the scope of work from them as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, let's, Sarah, can you do the whereas? Wow.
Sure. And when I say CPA and CPC, they're not abbreviated in the resolution. I'm just making sure. Whereas First Churches of Northampton submitted an application for CPA funding for restoration of 12 historic stained glass windows located in the sanctuary of First Churches of Northampton. Whereas CPA funds will be used to restore an important historic resource that is valued by the community and the region on which Mass Historic holds a permanent preservation restriction. Whereas the project will enable these important historic artifacts to remain in Northampton. Whereas in addition to being an important historic resource, First Churches provides valuable social services and meeting space to the community. Whereas all work will be consistent with the Secretary of the Interior standards for the treatment of historic properties. Whereas on April 20th, 2016, the Community Preservation Committee voted unanimously to recommend that $213,000 in CPA funds be used to support the restoration of the Tiffany and Rose stained glass windows included in the application.
Okay, I make 25 windows.
Anyone
on the sanctuary?
I don't think we're, there's 25 total windows, but I don't think we're asking. Gotcha.
Yeah, I think we're just the sanctuary windows, which are like 12 to 14 windows in the sanctuary.
You might say, whereas of the requested windows, we voted to do two, I don't know. I mean, I'm fine with the way it reads, but
yeah.
It's just,
yeah. I'm also concerned if it was 12 and it was actually 14, because we're not.
I was impressed at the number of social agencies that use the church building during the course of a week or month. What was that number, 60 or 70 or something?
It's pretty high. Well, especially because there's a lot of one-shot deals where, you know, people come through and we have speakers, but I think there's 27 on a regular monthly basis.
27. Yeah. Would you mind putting that in, Sarah? Because I think that was an eye opener. I think we'll help people.
You want that to be that specific?
Well, yeah, well, this is not the US Constitution, this is just a whereas this going to the city council, but I want the city councilors to know that First Church is that beneficent to the community.
I think it's also just useful for a researcher 100 years from now, like read city council and the records and say, oh, things that happened in this church, why, so this is why it was important to people.
So is that a separate whereas, or we?
No, it's just in, it's already the same.
Where she's got meetings.
So, how would that be? So whereas, in addition to being an important historic resource, First Church provides valuable social services and meeting space to the community and for.
To at least 27 different agencies.
Organizations. Or groups, maybe not organizations.
Whatever Brian says. I know it's trivial, but in one level, but I think it's also persuasive, and it helps. Well, the other reason I like it is that it preserves the identity of the building as a meeting house, which is very important, and it's really part of the to me part of the reason for it's why we should support it as different from other churches, because it is historically the town meeting house.
Can you read that?
So whereas, in addition to being an important historic resource, First Church provides valuable social services and meeting space to at least 27 different organizations and the community at large.
Okay, are we good on that?
27.
Well, that's the number.
You need a monthly or something. I mean, it's a weird number.
Oh, so it's 27 of a monthly.
That's fine.
A bit of more.
I know. Yeah. I agree with
it, if that helps.
Otherwise, it seems on that 27 over the course of its 100-year history, it's not that great.
So you would like that?
Well, I don't know. I put a number in there.
So add on a monthly basis. And I changed the last one, so now it reads, whereas on April 20th, 2016, the Hampton Community Preservation Committee voted unanimously to recommend that $230,000 in Community Preservation Act funds be used to support the restoration of two of the stained glass windows, semicolon, the Tiffany and Rose, that were included in the application.
And do we need to justify why those two?
No.
In the cover letter.
That's what you're going to City Council for.
Okay. Anything else on that? Good to go? Okay. Do we need another motion to accept as proposed all, how many of them are there, sir? Eight, so? Nine? Does it make sense to have a one motion?
There are eight.
Approval for these eight? Is there such a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Is there discussion? All those in favor? All those opposed? All right. Hoorah.
All right, so when would we like to meet again? So
well, hold on, wait a minute.
These will go.
We still have the leads thing to go through.
Okay.
So let's do that real quick, if we can.
Don't let me forget. Seven.
No, no, no.
Yep.
So, thank you.
Hope you get home soon.
So we have the thing that Sarah sent out and then sent out again, which is our small grants project, which is the Leeds signage for the 2860. And Sarah, what do we need to do on this? We need to look specifically at the conditions, is that correct?
There really aren't any for this one that I can come up with. So if you want to add anything, then now would be the time to do that.
Okay. So new folks, you can see this is the difference between a city council order and a memorandum of agreement. We can be, obviously it's much more explicit in terms of what the expectations are. And also this is a place to put on any conditions. So rather than reading this in full, hopefully you've had a chance to do that. Are there specific conditions that we want set on this? Other than the, that the fact that they're identifying that they're, that we funded them. Anything?
Now I'm fine.
Yeah. Everybody good on this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, do we need a motion here?
Yep.
So moved.
Second?
All in favor?
David Linda.
Opposed? All right. Way to go. Let's see. Other business not foreseen when agenda was published. And that would be setting up a date for a next meeting to go over specific, and the purpose would be specific conditions, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
So same as what we just did for the lead signage, but a lot of these will have a lot more conditions. So these will go to council on the 19th. We don't have to wait until they're approved to have this discussion. So we could do it 2 weeks from today, or if that doesn't work, we can do it later.
Keep me on schedule, 2 weeks from today.
2 weeks from today is the 18th. I will be otherwise engaged, but my co-chair, I'm sure, would love to handle that.
Mm-hmm. I will be otherwise engaged as well.
I will not be otherwise engaged, and we will try to return the group to you and co-chair.
Well, who else can make it? Yes, yes.
Is that reluctance, or are you?
Wow, that was almost painful to watch.
Well, wait a minute, we don't know about Julia, that's three of us.
I like
no, just two of us that can.
When we read those.
Right?
I can do it.
You can do it. Okay, so that's five that can and two that can. So it makes probably makes sense to go ahead on the 18th to keep us? Yes? Of course, you good on that? Okay.
And if anybody that can't make it, or even if you can, if you think of anything, you definitely want included, feel free to pass it along.
Just a curiosity, for the two that are not here, if they could not make it on that day, do we have quorum?
We should. Mm-hmm. Because we'll have, well, we don't know about Julia, but we'll have five who said yes, and that gives us a quorum.
And we're only down Julia, because we don't have the help of that.
Great. Apologize. Any other business to, and then we're thinking this, that will be it for us.
And there's no more business for this round after that.
Yeah, we spent all the money.
That's
yeah.
Right.
We don't
have a plan this year.
There
isn't any money.
There are CPCs that work that way. They'll meet once a year and bond everything and just, you know.
Okay, good to go.
Yeah. So, give me before you do about the meeting. This is the last one in the series up, but when do you foresee picking back up? Just give me a ballpark so I can get it. It's not a meeting on a month.
I mean, will we need to meet before September?
I don't think so. And
okay. I'll take that.
If anyone tries to submit an expedited application, I'll strongly advise them it's not a very good idea.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks.
So
September.
So we're looking at the first Wednesday in September, yeah. Correct?
And if something comes up, I'll let everybody know.
Yes.
I know.
Motion to adjourn.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Hurrah!